It's not a good situation down here right now. We're open up down. We're down another 17 S&Ps. S&Ps are trading 795. It's new territory right now.
We're testing the lows from 03. I think 780 was the old low from 2003, and we're actually breaking through it. So, I mean, this is historic in nature.
Market's at a five-year low. We have problems. We're 45% off our high. Market's lost half its value right now. There's trouble.
There's a lot of people thinking, I can't believe it, we broke 820. I can't believe we broke 800. Disbelief keeps elevating on a weekly basis.
One half under half. There's problems in the market right now, real serious problems. I don't think we're going to get a bounce. It could be ugly today.
These are absolutely delicate times. People haven't seen this type of market.
Right.
I mean, nothing like this. This is absolutely making history.
Oh, it's been a complete wipeout. Wipeout.
Customers really are unsure in this market. We have a lot of guys here who have been on the trading floor for over 20 years. And even some of those guys, in talking with them, they're like, you know what? Yeah, we've lost money too.
Stock closed at 605, and the best offer right now is 635, so I don't think you really want to do that. The crazy thing is, it never looks like the market can rally.
I've lost money, no question. Yeah, I'll fill you in later. On top of that, today is expiration Friday, and the tension is pretty thick.
Is he getting through group one or two? Or?
Six swim, Scott, may I help you?
Third Friday of every month is expiration Friday, and in the options world, that's the busiest day.
You want it to open lower.
We tell people expiration week, which is the week leading up to that Friday.
No vacations, no days off.
No anything, you show up for work unless you're dead.
This is a very strange city, and only in Chicago will you hear a parent say, we can't go away that week, it's expiration week.
With everything going on in the market and it being expiration Friday, there's exceptional trading activity. So the trade desk is under a lot of stress. So everybody just kind of has to step up their game a little bit.
It's a gray, rainy day in New York, and I headed over to a restaurant to meet Ron Shear. Ron is a very well-respected trader. He's a great guy to talk to about Wall Street. And hopefully I'll get one or two good ideas that I want to pursue going forward. Ron ran a very successful broker-dealer trading platform. He sold the business somewhere near the highs, and he's getting antsy, and he sees opportunity here in the embers of this crash.
What's doing today?
Want to go upstairs?
Want to sit upstairs? Okay, we'll sit upstairs.
Good.
All right, thank you.
Ron is a sophisticated investor. You know, we will look to work together on some level.
What's good in the world?
The stakes are good.
The stakes are good. The rest of the world's got problems.
So we're winding down one of the worst years in history.
Mm-hmm.
What the hell happened?
You're coming out of something, I guess you might call it a fool's paradise. I always said that the dirty little secret in Wall Street was leverage. If you look back 5-6 years ago, they borrowed a lot of money, but they had to put up some slice of equity in their own money. Maybe they put up 35 or 40%. Now they got to a point where you only had to put up 20 cents on the dollar. Well, if you only put up 20 cents on a dollar and you buy Harrah's Gaming like somebody did and people stop going to Vegas because the economy slows, there you go.
Right.
When you have management at these large Wall Street firms and banks that are public companies, they have no downside to the risk, but it's stockholders' risk. So what happens is the management's all geared up to the bonus system and the stock option system. The management goes out and takes all this trading risk, they leverage up. Now they have 2 good years. They're getting checks, millions and millions of dollars in checks. They don't have their name on the door. No one knows them if it falls apart. And they didn't take any risk. It wasn't their money.
Two and a half.
5% was S-bond, 5% was Misty. I need 10%. I got 10 between three of you guys.
It's hard to believe. Just a year ago, the market was trading at near record highs.
Here's a chart of the S&P 500 index. You're going back 10 years, and this is pretty telling. Let's go back to October of 2002, and you can see here a low of 768. Now let's slide over to here we are testing these highs of 2007. And then the big break, and look at how steep this decline was, and we see a low of 776 as of today. So basically about 8 points above that low that was put in place in October of 2002.
At 12. 885.
It's critical for this market to hold these levels. It represents a bottoming process that occurred when the internet bubble burst, and now we need to see it hold to here for people to gain confidence in the market to start investing again.
So we've got about 10 points to go. And after that, it will be new lows for this market dating back to the mid-90s.
Kenny, it's Phil. We're going to come down to see you in about 10 minutes.
Today, I need to go to my tail. I need to get my suit adjusted.
We're here in Wall Street. We have a certain image to uphold. First impressions are very important, and you have to look the part and dress the part.
All right, so I'll see you in 10. Bye.
Phil's asked me for my opinion on some new suits.
You excited?
Well, you know.
It's new clothes, it's always exciting.
We have one of the best tailors here in Manhattan. He's a great guy, and he keeps us looking sharp.
Go see Mr. Kenny Wong.
Yeah, it's like on and off. You know, it drizzles, then it pours. After you.
How you doing?
Hi, nice to
you. All right.
Hi.
How's everything?
I'm here for a new overcoat and another suit.
Okay, I have the fabric ready.
And a lot of people down here on Wall Street come here to Wong's Tailor. This is the guy that you want to see.
When the custom made suit, it doesn't matter you close the front or you don't leave it open, the front panel not going to change. For men's suit, most important, that's the lapel here and the sleeves and the waist. Yes.
Thing about Kenny is I'm not going to have you wearing the same suit as me. My suit is my suit. That's it. It's the Kenny Wong, Phil BOSSARD, one of a kind.
You could go for a lighter gray.
That ash is not bad. That ash gray, go down, 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 boom.
He picky, but he know what he want, what he like it.
I am a pain in the ass when it comes to the styling and the clothes, but Ken knows how to deal with me.
You lose weight?
I lost a lot of weight. Look, yeah, my belt is loose. on the last buckle.
This is nice. I picked the navy blue suit and a charcoal gray cashmere overcoat. Ken, thanks again.
Anytime.
And I'll see you soon, okay, buddy?
It's been a very, very interesting year for BOSSARD and BOSSARD. My brother Ken is now permanently based in Miami, and I'm still here with the gloomy skies and the concrete jungle here in New York. I'm pretty jealous. Let me give him a call. We haven't caught up in a couple of days. Let me see if I can get him.
Hey, Phil. What's up?
Nothing here.
Freezing, as always in New York. How's the weather down there in Miami?
It's boiling hot right now, Phil. You don't even want to be here right now, to be honest with you.
I'm hating you right now, you know that? I gotta wear a hat and scarf and gloves. So how's the house treating you?
I mean, the house is pretty good. You know, I'm starting to feel a little homely here.
I'm glad that you made this move to Miami. It's giving us the exposure that we need.
This is probably one of the most powerful moves we've ever made.
But I need you down here. You gotta come down here. You're sitting on Wall Street.
You know, and I have some deals happening here.
When are you coming down?
Probably on the 23rd.
Okay.
Sounds good.
I'm a lucky guy. I get to work with my brother. Like everyone, we're faced with certain challenges right now.
Okay, bye.
But we're still optimistic. We'll see how things turn out for us.
Right now, we're trading a very scared market. I mean, I've never seen it like this. I've never seen it sustain this long.
We're down 50% nearly in the S&P 500, which hasn't happened since, I don't think, like the 70s and the Great Depression. It's horrible.
The market was down roughly like 47% in 1931. I think currently we're real close to that. The $12 push, but I did I ever think I'd be trading down here and see that or witness that? Never.
Worst case scenario, I think, is not only people like losing their homes, but I mean living on the streets and like, you know, scurrying for food again. I mean, those thoughts start to come in your head when you see something like this going on.
What's he doing? Everybody was waiting for the next crash, but everyone thought it would be a weak event. This has been a 2.5-3 month crash.
One bid! One bid!
Just when you think it's getting better, it's getting worse.
Right now, there just doesn't appear to be an end to it. It's really starting to play on the psychology of everybody down here.
There's a lot more edginess, a lot more uncertainty. I think people are looking for the bottom right now and they're not finding it. I think people are realizing, hey, this isn't working out as well as it was before. You know, the glory days are behind us.
There's panic in here. There's traders trying to cover positions.
There's nights when you go home and you're sweating in bed and thinking about the potential of what might happen, especially if you get hung on a position late in the day.
I mean, there are people that are no longer here over the last couple months, and there's trading firms that no longer exist. This market crash has got its fingers in everybody. The tension in the crowd, I mean, it's packed in and it's like a keg ready to explode out there, a powder keg, it really is.
This expiration Friday, there's more on the line.
They traded down to almost $3 today. I mean, it's pure insanity.
The public have really lost their confidence in the financial markets. This is unlike anything anybody's ever seen.
You know, we've jostled around. Early this morning, we were up.
Our call volume is exceptionally high. People's nerves, you know, they're a little anxious.
Battle stations for everybody. It's what we call an all-hands-on-deck situation.
Hey, Mark.
On expiration Friday, Donnie in particular needs to make sure that he is working directly with the team.
Hey, Bill.
Ensuring that customers are being contacted to help them mitigate risk.
We'll see what happens at the closing bell. See what happens.
Donnie's been here since the beginning.
When we first started Thinkorswim, we only had 20 employees. So now we have this whole block of customers, about 10,000 of them, that still think I'm the only one that works here. So they all email me directly. If you've been here with us from the beginning, I will answer every phone call. I will answer every email you send. That's his email address. God needs accounts linked. He'll be a tough person to deal with. Could you hold on 1 second? Let me call Christy.
Hello, this is Christy.
Hey, Rachel.
I feel bad because I've had to dump a lot of things that need to get done on my assistant. One of the most important reports that go out.
I keep hearing my name coming from the office.
Can I at least offer up Rachel for a little while to see if she can help you with this?
And she's saying, Rachel can do that. Rachel's really great. And I just like, oh my God, more?
At least get through bucket one. That's 25 million. That's half of the problem here. I have tasks I need to make sure are done before the bell.
She was always stealing my pens. I don't think I was prepared for what happened to the economy this year. Things have been really stressful. I, of course, am the front line, and I have to deal with these people calling and screaming at me. It's really not exactly what I expected when I took this job. I actually need to talk to Phil today about something pretty important. I'm just looking for the right time to do this.
Okay, I'll talk to you in a bit. No problem. Thank you.
Hey, Phil, do you have a second?
Why not? Come on in. Come on by. What's up, Beth?
I have come to a decision. As much as I love working for you guys and you guys are awesome, I don't feel like the world of finance is where I should be. It's really challenging for me.
I'm at a standstill right now. I can't believe this. I thought everything was going so well.
I've looked over the books and
it's like reading Chinese.
It's like Greek.
Yeah. I know. But we can get you a tutor and
I feel like a fish out of water still, and I thought that maybe I could just focus on something new and challenging and
wow. This is worse than the market plunging 1,000 points.
No,
today.
It's not. Don't even say that.
I mean, at least you're honest with yourself that passion isn't there. You know, I hope the best for you.
Thank you, Phil.
No problem. It's gonna be sad here without you.
Well, back to work.
I'm looking at the clock, it's 2:51. There's about 23 minutes left to the end of the day. Right now in the SPX, it's just falling apart out there. November contracts are all expiring, and we've sold off really hard in the last few minutes. We're down big, and we're going down further, it looks like, so it's pretty scary.
1080, 1180, 1080, 1180.
Here's that chart again, and here we are seeing the market fall off today. Currently, 747, so we're taking out these lows from 2002. And it's just unbelievable. What we're seeing right now, I mean, this is historical.
140,
130 or 110 a half?
1040.
This is a low going back, I don't even know how, it goes back to the mid-90s at best. So we're just seeing this market break down.
Sold!
Our group just sent a couple extra hands out there just to help process the order flow that's coming through all the terminals and through the phones.
You hear the volume levels on the floor have just picked up dramatically. I mean, you can hear the SPX over there. It's roaring. Fear is escalating, and it just looks like there's no end to the selling pressure on the market. It's like we're sitting here watching the decline of Western civilization in a really sad way. I mean, hopefully that's not the case. And the bell just sounded. There's 2 minutes left in the trading day.
It's been a long week. These guys are going to be counting the seconds until they get out of there and finish this day up.
That's a historic day for you right there. That's a historic day.
This is the lowest close, I think, since 2001. I mean, that's it's huge. The last 2 days, we've been down 120 S&Ps. I mean, you tell me, I don't know. It's a coin flip where we can be tomorrow morning. I don't know, but what I do know, there'll be a lot of sleepless nights tonight. We are basically 100 S&Ps below 1,000 Dow points below the last bottom that we got a real good bounce off. So where's the next one going to be? I don't know. I don't know if it's here. I don't know if it's 100 points now. This is a devastating situation right now. I mean, there's serious going on.
Hey, Tariq, Beth is going to love this. Why don't you grab some plates and stuff, and we'll set this up for her. I'm really going to miss Beth. Obviously, her heart really wasn't in this industry, and she just decided to resign today. So we went out and got her favorite cake, you know, wishing her good luck.
Surprise,
Beth. Oh, it's
best
so
of luck
oh
on
my God,
all your
you guys
adventures.
Thank you, Phil.
No problem.
I'm exhausted, and I've never seen anything like this. I can't emphasize that enough. Where we close today is alarming, really alarming. I mean, it's like, I don't even know how to put it into terms. The S&P has lost over 50% of its value. The Dow has lost over 50% of its value this year. That's scary. I mean, like I said, I never thought I'd see that in my lifetime. It's just beyond scary. Hopefully it rebounds. I don't think so, but hopefully it will.
This past year, while it's been fun and it's been an exciting time, it has been a roller coaster.
This year was incredible. It was an unbelievable year in the financial markets.
The beginning of the year, everything was rosy and great.
The market was touching highs. People were happy. Everybody was getting their salary. Everybody was making money.
My year, it started off beautifully. It was just humming along.
And then boom, all hell broke loose.
We all got caught in the crisis.
And we are in a mess down there.
Probably the driving force behind the crisis was greed on a lot of levels, from Washington to Main Street to Wall Street. It was a disastrous year. It was a year of deleveraging.
Who wants to talk about investments today? What they're thinking is, wow, 20 years of my retirement got wiped out in 8 months.
If your investor gets hurt, you know, you're hurt, so you're gonna have less money to work with.
We've been hit like everyone else. I've personally taken losses this year. Ken's taken losses this year.
But within this gloom, this is probably the best money-making environment of my career.
For me personally, with the market down 40% plus, I only had a small gain this year. But a gain in this market is better than anything. We'll get over this.
Cheers on the cake.
See the look in his eyes?
Cheers.
This industry is forever changing, and in time, this will pass.
Hey, Beth.
Gotta miss you.
You know what? Why don't you do me a favor?
You guys are gonna make her cry, man. Stop it.
I'm a Wall Streeter. It's in my blood. And I think that I'm really blessed and fortunate to have my brother and colleagues behind me. It's like my second family.
To look at what I do for a living, it's unique, it's competitive, it's the best thing I ever did, and I couldn't find myself anywhere else. Until somebody taps me on the shoulder and says, hey, old guy, get out of here. This is a young man's game. You and your walker, take a walk. You're done down here. You did a good job. I think I'll stay out there.
If I take a step back and look at where I want to go in the next few years, I'd love to take on a little bit of a different role within Think or Swim, maybe. And Tom and Scott are always there saying, you know what? Yeah, you have that idea? Roll with it. Let's see what you can do.
We're going to have a complete restructuring of Wall Street with almost a clean slate. Everyone's on even footing. I think we're going to come out of this a lot stronger. I feel like I've been training my whole life for an opportunity like this. And now it's time to rebuild.